college football is woven with rivalries. And here in Tallahassee, this clash of contrasting colors comes with plenty of heat on it. And on a day that's been filled with some of the best, we finish it under the lights with a game that's been part of these players' football lives for as long as they can remember. Eyes that look across at familiar faces. Former high school rivals now towing that line again. Lofty rankings, bright futures, and immediate results. From Doak Campbell Stadium here in Tallahassee, number 15 Florida, the Gators winners of the SEC East against 14th ranked Florida State. And what a day of rivalry football it has already been. An all-time classic was played earlier today between Michigan and Ohio State. The Buckeyes taking it in double overtime. And then the Iron Bowl, as mighty Alabama maintains their lofty position. Number one gets past Auburn. And because of the Ohio State win, it was all on the line for Penn State. The Nittany Lions beat Michigan State. They will now play in the Big Ten championship game. And as we say good evening, everybody, Joe Tessitore alongside Todd Blackledge. We'll say hello to Holly Rowe in just a moment. Those games had college football playoff implications. This game doesn't touch upon the college football playoff. However, boy, does it run deep for those involved in this rivalry. The state championship is
absolutely
on the line.
A lot on the line because these teams both have guys that played against each other, played with each other, a lot of familiarity between the players, and Florida State trying to do something they've never done, and that's a clean sweep in the last 4 years, beating both of their in-state rivals, Miami and Florida. They could go 8-0 with a win tonight. That's big for bragging rights at home and also on the recruiting trail in this state.
Listen, we love the juice of the rivalry, but I love the matchup on the field because this Florida State offense is loaded with talent, and the Florida defense, statistically, they're superb.
Amazing what Florida's defense has done overcoming the injuries that they've had to overcome. They're the third best defense in the country in scoring defense, fifth best in total defense, but they've not seen the kind of offensive combination that they'll see tonight out of Florida State. The skill of a running back like Dalvin Cook, plus a young quarterback, DeAndre Francois, with the kind of arm talent he has. Florida's faced some good teams. They haven't faced that kind of a combo.
Florida leads the all-time series, but Florida State has won five of the last six over the Gators. As always, our eyes and ears on the field. Holly Rowe. Good evening, Holly.
Good evening, Joe. Well, this is a more unusual rivalry because it didn't get started until the late 50s. That's because Florida State used to be a women's college back in the early 1900s. After World War II, they became coeducational, but the Florida Gators would not schedule them in football until the governor stepped in 1958 and said, you have to play. Well, the Seminole fans think that they have looked down their nose by these Florida Gator fans all those years, and that's why we see some of the pre-game activity. Guys have mixed it up over the years in this very heated, hated rivalry. Guys, I hate to tell you, though, in a disappointing fashion, it was not that dramatic out there on the field tonight, but when the Gators just took the field, they ran down in front of this Florida State student section and tried to get them a little bit fired up. We'll see if the familiarity breeds contempt and this hated rivalry spills over onto the field tonight.
Yeah, give it time, Holly. Give it time. Just wait. One of college football's greatest traditions. Chief Osceola and Renegade. In midfield, Doak Campbell rocking, and we are ready for the Gators and Noles again. Jimbo Fisher, 5-1 versus Florida, seventh year here, best winning percentage in ACC history. And all this guy has done, Jim McElwain, Todd, is go back-to-back in winning the SEC East in his first 2 years.
He inherited an outstanding defense from Will Muschamp, and he's had to piece it together offensively with multiple quarterbacks, and he's still found a way to Atlanta 2 years in a row.
And the big boom goes out the back of the end zone. as the grad transfer Austin Appleby leads the way.
Austin Appleby is a guy I'm very familiar with. He's from my hometown in North Canton, Ohio. He is a student of the game, and that's why he was one of Trent Dilfer's favorite guys in the Elite 11 because of how he studies. He's a big, sturdy guy, big, strong arm, and also his maturity. He's a graduate transfer, and I think that will really pay off. It did last week in Baton Rouge, and they're counting on that maturity tonight here at Doak Walker Stadium as well.
Graduated from Purdue, the first graduate transfer to be a starting quarterback at Florida. This his fifth start. Play action to get the night going for Appleby as he dumps it off to the tight end, Goolsby. Let's take a look at tonight's Chick-fil-A impact players. And we'll start with the Gators running back, Jordan Scarlett, has three 100-yard games among his last five. Antonio Callaway is the best downfield option for Florida. But DeMarcus Walker for Florida State up front, 13 sacks on the year.
Well, they lead the nation in sacks, and when they get you in predictable situations, that's when they're at their best. Very important for Appleby to keep the Gators on schedule.
Second and five run for Scarlett as he gets to the edge and has a first down and a great looking effort for 13 yards from Jordan Scarlett.
This kid impressed me watching him against LSU a week ago. He runs really hard. They've got receivers that have to block on the perimeter. You see their best wide receiver blocker, Ahmad Fullwood, number five, out there leading the way. But Scarlett runs with a lot of physicality and breaks arm tackle.
They go with the end around with Callaway. Let's see if he can turn it on, and he can. A big gainer for Antonio Callaway.
Nice way to slow down the pass rushers. We talked about DeMarcus Walker. Going to run this reverse right back at him. He got pulled inside a little bit too far, and Callaway able to turn the corner, and a nice blend of plays so far by the Florida offense.
24-yard run helped out with a downfield block from Josh Hammond. Here's LaMichael Perine out of the backfield, and he was tracked down right away by McFadden.
One of the guys that we weren't sure we were going to see tonight, Martez Ivey, the left guard for Florida. He's in there, started the ball game, was a little nicked up. We weren't sure if he was going to be able to go or not. That's a good sign for Florida in this offensive line. No seniors on their entire depth chart up front on the offensive line.
Second and nine now. Appleby, a little pressure up the middle. Smartly gets it to Perine, and Perine makes his way inside the 10. It'll be first and goal, Gators.
Perine got lost. They had two tight ends to that side in the wing. The receivers went inside, and nobody got outside with Perine. A good quick read by Appleby, but credit the design and the formation that fooled the Florida State defense there. Florida uses multiple tight ends, and they move them and shift them a lot to create an advantage, and they did that time.
Not much happening in the middle of that Noles defense as Perine hit a wall. It was Derek Nottie up front making the tackle.
One of the areas that's been tough for Florida this year, their ability to score touchdowns in the red zone. 37 red zone opportunities, but only 19 touchdowns. That's a little over 50%. That's not good enough for to be a championship offensive team. I think the quarterback, Austin Appleby, is going to have to make some plays as a runner in this part of the field.
They shift both stack tight ends now to the right side here on second and goal. Appleby searching for options, and at the line of scrimmage he was looking for Lewis, but it's incomplete.
I think they were looking to throw back to Fullwood, but it was covered well by Florida State. Appleby had to go to a secondary receiver, but I think they were trying to roll right and throw it back across the formation to Fullwood. But good discipline by the Seminole defense. This is where, if you're Austin Appleby, take care of the football. You're not going to be able to hold it very long. The two guys on the end rushing the passer, Walker and Burns, two of the best, 99 and 44.
Third and goal, Appleby. That's complete, but short of the goal line to Brandon Powell, as Trey Marshall was there defensively.
Really a good strong tackle by Trey Marshall. He went high against the smaller wide receiver Powell, and Powell was not able to get that ball forward at all.
Very first drive of this game, and it's being played with this level of intensity. Ninth play of the drive for the Gators. Fourth and goal. Appleby pressured to the end zone, and it falls incomplete. It was Trey Marshall coming in hard. Jimbo's defense does their job after the Gators marched right down. McElwain and company rolled the dice and came up empty.
Well, they really brought a creative pressure that time. Marshall was lined up on the slot and got to Appleby before he could make an accurate throw.
So now Florida State from the 2-yard line, as Cook will give them plenty of breathing room out to the 9. Todd, what is your take on the redshirt freshman DeAndre Francois?
Well, there's a lot to like about him. First of all, the kid has really tremendous arm talent. At 6'2", 205 pounds, he's a freshman. He can make every throw on the field. He has a very calm demeanor and very calm feet in the pocket. And that preparation 101 over the last 4 or 5 weeks, he has really learned how to study film and prepare as a championship quarterback. Future very bright for this young guy.
Second and 4, as it'll be third and about 2. Chick-fil-A impact players. You just saw Dalvin Cook, over 4,100 career rushing yards now, number 3 in ACC history. Travis Rudolph has had an outstanding career as well as the receiver. And Tease Tabor, 4 interceptions this year, 9 for his career for the Gators. They are very strong in the defensive backfield.
Mentioned at the top of the show, the combination of the throwing ability of Francois and the all-around ability of Dalvin Cook. Florida has not seen that kind of a combination, and Cook crushed him last year.
Third and a long one, and an easy pitch and catch to Ryan Izzo, who muscles his way out beyond the 20-yard line.
Nice job moving the pocket, moving the quarterback, Francois. And this is a very safe, easy throw to the sideline. Bootleg, fake it to Cook on third and short. And a nice, easy throw to Izzo for Francois.
Francois to pass again. And Cook snags it, makes 2 cuts, instantly lowers a shoulder, and is just short of the 30. Well, we told you the career leader in rush yards at Florida State, the first ACC player to rush for over 4,000 yards in just 3 seasons. Second most single season rush yards here in 2016. Had a great performance last week against Syracuse, going for 225. And 4 TDs. Second and 2 now. As they run counter, Izzo with a really good block, and Dalvin Cook is off to a good start time.
Last year in this ball game, 183 yards, and he took over the game in the fourth quarter. He is an outstanding back. This is just going to get to the outside. He gets a nice block from his tight end, Saunders, number 88. Good pull block by Wilson Bell. And as fast as he is, he also has the ability to run with tempo and set up blocks as well as anybody in college football.
Patrick now in at running back. As here he comes out of the backfield. And a flag is down as they wrestle Jaquez Patrick down to the ground. That was David Reese with the tackle.
Personal foul, face mask, number 7 on the defense, 15-yard penalty, first down.
That's on Duke Dawson.
Yeah, it was away from the throw. It was actually Duke Dawson working on a guy who was trying to block him. There it is right there. He's just going to throw him out of the way with the face mask, and that's an obvious call and an easy call to make. And Florida State now with outstanding field position.
Keep in mind, this drive started just moments ago on their own 2-yard line. Here goes Dalvin Cook.
Watching Dalvin Cook on film and talking to coaches on both teams, they all say this guy is going to be an every down player at the next level. Not only a terrific runner and great burst and a big play ability, excellent receiver out of the backfield, already 28 catches on the season, and he's also a good pass protector, which you don't normally see in feature backs. He is equipped to play at the next level on every down.
Second and 3, patient, then explosive, and a touchdown for the Noles.
Really nice job of blocking by the left side and the center, Ellerby. Watch Ellerby get to the second level on the linebacker. Fullback gets a part of the middle linebacker, and that's all that Dalvin Cook needs. Again, as fast as he is patient enough to allow blocks to set up and then burst through the opening.
...17-yard touchdown run by Dalvin Cook. 45 now in his career. Keep that record book open. He's gonna have more to do. The Noles off the turnover and into the end zone. 7-0 early in Tallahassee. Mr. Cook from Miami Central High gets the Noles up a touchdown early.
Excellent blocking, getting to the second level. Watch the center, Ellerby, get here. The fullback's going to get a piece of this linebacker, and Dalvin Cook shows the patience to find that crease and then explode through it. Dalvin Cook, he's played excellent, over 100 yards the last 2 years against Florida. Right now, 52 yards and averaging over 10 yards per carry.
Chris Thompson on the return here. Ball is out, and he has to leap back to jump on it inside the 10-yard line. Start on the ground here with Scarlett. Let's go to the field to Holly.
Well, Austin Appleby is from Hoover, North Canton in Ohio, and went to the high school that Todd Blackledge, our young man in the booth, went to. They were both quarterbacks there. Austin actually went to a quarterback camp that Todd helped him at, and of course, Todd was also his assistant basketball coach in high school. Some real similarities with our Todd Blackledge in the booth and Austin Appleby down on the field tonight.
So this had to be an easy week of prep for you, my friend.
Well, yeah, it's kind of exciting for me. I didn't like that fumble a couple plays ago, but I sure like seeing him play and what has happened in his career.
Powell is taken down by Marquez Watt. I like seeing those pictures of you outside the booth as a basketball coach. And here we are, Appleby and you, Canton North Hoover, side by side, separated by a few years.
Yeah, and a lot of years separate us, but the uniforms are the same.
This is your visit pregame with Austin Appleby.
Yeah, really happy for him. Graduate transfer from Purdue and kind of living the dream here the last few weeks. But in a tough spot right now, 3rd and 9, backed up by his own goal line.
As he sprints near side, and he threw it low and incomplete as he was looking for Powell. So now they're going to have to punt their way out of a hole. And they're well equipped to do that with Johnny Townsend, an outstanding punter. Rooney Murray, who is setting up shop at midfield. So the Noles should have great field position again. Townsend averages 47.8 per punt. This one is driven low, so an opportunity for a return, but good coverage that time by the Gators. Just a 38-yard punt. Thompson with the tackle. As Cook drives ahead to the 45.
This Florida State team, one of the things we talk about at this point in the season, injuries, how much stability they have on their offense and defensive lines. Six different offensive line combinations for this Florida State team through this point of the season. Hard to develop continuity and consistency, and yet their young quarterback has had an outstanding season.
Cook's going to be a great one. Nice cut, and then gets to the outside, shakes free, gives a little more inside the 10.
Well, he follows his fullback again. I want you to watch the patience of Dalvin Cook running behind his fullback, Freddie Stevenson. Here's the fullback. Watch him just wait right on his hip till he seals that block, then cuts inside. I mean, you normally don't see guys with that kind of speed that Cook has run that patiently. But he is a unique combination of speed and patience.
He is a fully developed running back. Every facet of the game. First and goal, Noles.
I thought one of the best things I ever heard a coach say about a player, Jimbo Fisher told us in his office yesterday. He said from the time he got here, he was highly recruited, highly regarded, said he was one of the most unentitled players that he's ever been around. He's a guy's guy. The players love him. Very selfless player. And it's just great to see a guy with that kind of attitude and mentality be as good as he is.
He doesn't care. He doesn't care if he's a decoy on a play, if he has to block on a play, get involved in the passing game with protection. And as we come to the end of the first quarter, he may be sitting on another one. It was Cook who got them on the board. 87 yards rushing and a score for Dalvin. 7-0 Florida State on top of the Gators. Saturday Night Football will continue after this message and a word from our ABC stations.
One of the things Florida State has been outstanding all season, their red zone offense. Conversely, Florida has been just as dominant red zone defense, particularly when it comes to touchdowns.
Just ask LSU how good they were in spots like this a week ago, shutting down the Tigers time and time again. And at the end, with the game on the line, Francois pumps, then goes to the end zone, and it was almost intercepted by Tabor.
Well, he had both hands on it. You know, I saw a play in the North Carolina State game a couple weeks ago at Florida State where an interception was dropped, and the very next play, Francois threw a touchdown. These are ones you don't get back. As good as Tabor is, they have a chance to snuff out this drive in the red zone, and he's just not able to make the catch.
Cook checks back in now on third and goal.
Francois can run also. They don't ask him too much.
That was beyond the reach that time as he was looking for Travis Rudolph, and it was Tease Tabor again on coverage.
Well, we've seen Wilson and Tabor both make big plays. Man-to-man coverage, inside technique, gets back outside and gets his right hand on the football. That's well done by Tease Tabor. Missed the interception, but came back and got the stop on third down.
So a more manageable field goal attempt now for Ricky Aguayo. Just a 22-yarder, does have that angle. Missed on the long attempt of 49 earlier. As the freshman will grab three for the Noles. 10-0 on top at home.
I think this is a really important drive offensively for Florida. They started the game with a 9-play drive. It came up empty on fourth down. But they've got to let this defense, this injury-depleted defense, rest a little bit.
First down pass, going to take a shot downfield, and it's incomplete, looking for Tyree Cleveland. Here's Scarlett as he cuts back and gets to the 40-yard line. Josh Sweat with the tackle.
Talked about DeMarcus Walker, second in the nation, coming into the game with 13 sacks. The young freshman, Brian Burns, number 99, built a little bit like a wide receiver at 6'5", 220 pounds. But he has 8 sacks to lead all freshmen in college football as well.
Third and 5. Callaway's to the top of your screen, matched up with McFadden. Runs the slant there. Can he get there? Dragged down, kept his balance, and rolls ahead.
Wow.
That mark should give him the first down.
Tremendous effort and a good job by Austin Appleby getting the ball out of his hands quickly. It's a one-step slant. Get it to your best playmaker. And then Callaway, who actually lost the first down trying to make a bigger play, able to still get past that marker and extend the drive. Again, a critical drive for Florida to rest their defense.
Fourth and 1. From their own 45.
You got a 6'5", 240-pound quarterback, too.
That's going to be close. Maybe that second effort there.
Second effort, I think, got him. You know, you can push a runner from behind. You can't pull him forward, but you can push from behind. They needed less than a yard. He got pushed back, and then I think Scarlett pushing at the end might have got him the first down.
And it is a first down for Florida.
After that conversion, midfield, now I think you got to try take another shot for a big chunk play off of play action. They've done a pretty good job of moving Austin Appleby in the pocket, giving him different launch points.
First down at the 43. Scarlett getting plenty of work here. Kept his balance magnificently well for another first down.
Nice job by Goolsby, number 30, the tight end. He's in a wing formation. Watch number 30. He leaves one block, gets out onto a second block on the linebacker, and Scarlett again showing you that physical running style that he has shown all season, breaking arm tackles and a 9-yard gain.
He just runs hungry.
He does.
Second and 1. Why not? Keep feeding him inside the 30 with Jordan Scarlett.
That same 3 wide receiver bunch formation with 2 tight ends and a big wide receiver in Ahmad Fullwood. And Scarlett doing a nice job running behind that. Jordan Cronkite. Cronkright into the ballgame now, number 32 at running back. He is more of their third down throwing running back. Might be a pass here on this first down play with him in the ballgame.
And it is time. As he tried to check down to Powell, second and 10.
Well, they were looking for Cronkright first on a little wheel route. Powell was going in the flat, and he might have had him. He gave up on him too early, I think. They put Cronkright into the game to run that particular pattern, and I think Appleby gave up on the play a little bit too early.
three receivers to the top of your screen, including Callaway. That's Cleveland in motion. And P. Ryan gets the call. Waited for a block. Yeah, lost his mouthpiece there on impact and gets himself down to the 21-yard line.
Michael P. Ryan, a freshman out of Theodore, Alabama, 5'11", 221 pounds, also has shown a real physical running style and a nice compliment to Jordan Scarlett, who's now back in the game on third down.
You said the Florida defense needs a rest. The offense had to provide something. 15th play of the drive now.
Exactly what they needed. Now, obviously, they would love to have points as well, but part one of the mission accomplished.
Third and four. Appleby, a little bit of pressure, thrown high and breaking it up was White as he was trying to find Callaway.
Well, this is the second time in a row where Florida State has brought pressure from the perimeter and the back, Scarlett, doesn't get there. Watch Scarlett looking inside and the pressure is going to come from outside. If Jordan Scarlett just gets his eyes scanning quicker, he picks up that blitz and Appleby has a chance to make the throw. That's two plays that Jordan Scarlett just has not been able to get his eyes moving fast enough on where the pressure's coming from.
The wildly talented kicker, Eddie Pinheiro, on to attempt the 38-yarder. As Florida gets on the board. 10-3 game. Well managed drive that took 16 plays and finished with the field goal. Saturday Night Football on ABC, presented by Walmart. 10-3 Noles, glad you're with us. Joe Tessitore, Todd Blackledge, Holly Rowe with you here in Tallahassee, one of the great rivalries of the sports.
Florida got points and they held the ball for almost 7.5 minutes to rest their defense.
As the flag will come out here as he's angled out of bounds to the sideline.
Free kick out of bounds. Kicking team.
Setting up the screen. Cook. Wow. Taken down right away by Johnson.
Really nice play by Johnson.
The foul, roughing the passer, number 96, defense. 15-yard penalty.
But a costly mistake by C.C. Jefferson, roughing the passer.
Yeah, and an easy call, too. No need for it by Jefferson. He's just going to two-hand shove him at the end of the play. Plays go over. Your teammate just made a great play, and you've negated it with a foolish penalty.
See, last week against LSU, keeping it clean. And right there. 15 and a first down with under 2.5 to play in this first half as Florida State is past midfield. Lead blocking that time for Francois was Cook as he darts out inside the 40.
This is a play they used against BC quite a bit. They set the formation with the tight end Izzo and Dalvin Cook the back to that side, to the wide side, and it's a design quarterback sweep. Had a lot of success against the Eagles with that play. And a nice gain on that first down carry by Francois.
College football playoff. New rankings will be revealed Tuesday night. Be interesting to see how people start framing the argument of the Big Ten.
There's Fullwood still getting looked at, talked to. Took that shot to the head.
Cook. With ease inside the 30. 12-yard run for Dalvin Cook.
Again, the patience of Dalvin Cook to just string this play out and wait for the block from Tate. Watch him string it, get a block by the receiver and cut inside of it and pick up the first down.
Coming up on a C note. Already 96 yards in this first half. Francois incomplete. He was trying to find Izzo.
Well, he couldn't step into the throw because of Brant Brantley. Brantley got pressure, hit him right as he threw the football, and that's why the ball was not thrown accurately for a touchdown. Watch 57 in the middle. Get quick pressure into Francois, and that's why the ball was thrown behind Izzo, or that would have been a touchdown. Wilson able to get his hand on the football because it was thrown behind Izzo.
Jimbo Fisher said, we were asking him about Brantley yesterday. He said he's just a pain to play.
Yeah. In the last 3 or 4 weeks, he's been
unblockable. Second and 10 now. Francois with time. And that was beyond the reach of Tate as Tabor had coverage again. Capital One halftime is going to be coming your way with Stan, Mac, and Mark. Give you all the scores and highlights. It was an awesome Saturday of rivalry football. That is coming up right here on ABC, the Capital One halftime report.
I think if you're Florida here defensively, you better pay attention to this guy coming out of the backfield on this third down passing situation.
Florida nearly jumped, settled in back on side. Third down and 10. Quick strike, and it was batted as he tried to get to the intended target.
Kylan Johnson got a hand on the football, I think. He's made a couple nice plays in this drive. Dropped right into the passing lane. Got his hands on the football. And a nice stop by the Gator defense.
And with that stop, it'll bring Ricky Aguayo onto the field for a 44-yard attempt. Remember, he didn't make good ball contact when he attempted from 49 earlier. And this is blocked. Florida blocks the field goal attempt by Aguayo. His 49-yarder was hit low and got under it. And here they get a big paw on it as Joey Ivey is celebrating.
Yeah, Joey Ivey's the guy who kind of knifed in there and got his hand on the football. It was an extremely low kick. Watch Ivey right in the center here, just kind of knife in sideways and get a big hand up right between the center and the guard, and with his right hand knock that ball away.
Cook was a lot to deal with. He had 96 yards and a touchdown. But the defense for the Gators did their job as well. 10-3 game. The Capital One halftime report still to come after these messages.
Well, Coach, the good news is Dalvin Cook with 96 yards in that first half against a really stout Florida defense. What's allowing him to have that kind of success?
I think we're blocking up front, and we're getting the blocks downfield, and we're getting them spread, and Dalvin's just a heck of a player.
The problem is, though, your field goal kicker struggled two different kicks now. Yep. How do you fix that?
Well, we got to talk to him, and we got another field goal kicker that we can put in there, too.
Who would that be?
Logan.
Thanks, Tim.
Beautiful night here in Tallahassee, and it always is a great rivalry game between the Noles and the Gators. 10-3 right now, Todd. Hey, it was that short field. Yeah. That's really the difference in this game, that short field after the turnover that led to the Florida State score.
Yeah, we talked about the combination offensively Florida State would throw at this Florida defense. Dalvin Cook had a big first half, but the throwing game of Florida State, Florida did a good job. Their pass defense neutralized DeAndre Francois in that passing game. Offensively for Florida, 0-for-6 on third downs in that first half. They've got to find a way to convert. They were pretty good coming into this game on third downs. Tonight have not been very good.
Yeah, Cook with 96 yards in that first half. Did have the touchdown run as Florida State will get control of things to start it off as we go down to Holly for AT&T Inside Access.
Kicking team.
Just one score in this rivalry game. What can you do to get your offense a little bit more consistent here in the second half?
Well, big thing is we need to find a couple of explosive plays somewhere. And, you know, our guys are doing a good job of battling. They're hanging in there and playing their tails off. And we just got to find an explosive here and there, keep playing with consistency, but more than that, just hang in there and keep pounding.
You guys did a better job in the second quarter eliminating Dalvin Cook, but how can you do a better job against the rush?
You know, they got us on some counters and stuff. We just got to do a good job of, first of all, setting the edges, and then we got to get guys around the ball, and with him, you got to wrap them up.
Thank you, Coach.
You bet.
Really nice play by Davis. because he was fighting off a block the whole way. Watch 95, fight off the block, and with one hand, fight off the block with one, and get the tackle with the other hand. That's a heck of a play by Davis.
Devonis Davis has a bright future on that defensive line, second and eight.
As Gardner, the freshman now on the return. Time and time again, the Gators ask a lot of their defense, and they deliver.
It's man coverage underneath with a free safety patrolling the back of the defense. That was Gardner. Here's Gardner. He's going to be the free safety, but they're locked up in man everywhere else. And because of the tight underneath coverage, the free safety's able to read the eyes of the quarterback, get to the overthrown ball, and get a big turnover for the Gator defense. We saw a turnover be the play of the game in the first half for Florida State. Can the Gators capitalize on a short field now after that turnover?
The big-time recruit, his first college start with all the injuries at safety, and he comes up big. Now, can the Gators cash in? Appleby. That was beyond the hope of Lewis there. There is Gardner. Chauncey Gardner. Yeah, you can write your name on the board.
I like the idea of throwing on first down because of the struggles they've had on third. But you got to make some connections. Second and 10 against this defense. Pretty tough duty.
Here's that shift over to the near side. They've run out of this formation before, and they go right to that same spot. But thrown back by DeMarcus Walker is Scarlett.
Boy, beautiful play by Walker. He's being blocked by the tight end, Lewis. And he just gets both hands inside on the tight end. Right here it is. 80 against 44. Both hands inside, sheds the block, and makes the tackle. We know he's a great pass rusher. That was excellent run defense by the defensive end.
These are the spots that he's built for. As Brian Burns, too, long, lanky freshman who loves coming after the quarterback. Third and seven. Appleby downfield.
Just overthrew him. He had Callaway open on the corner route. He's got separation, and the ball is a slightly overthrown for Callaway. Good protection. Good isolation route. Might have been caught.
Yep. If he got rid
better
of it,
throw than I thought.
A hair sooner,
yes. Perhaps. Maybe a little sooner.
Pinheiro on now for the 41-yard attempt. He just slices right through it. So the interception leads to three. 10-6 game here in Tallahassee. Eddie Pinheiro, by the way, ninth field goal this year of over 40 yards. That's a school record as he is set to kick away. Kermit Whitfield back to return. Whitfield on the jet motion as he shakes his way out to the 44-yard line, met by Harris. Second and five. Cook. Just a gain of a couple. C.C. Jefferson with the tackle.
Johnson on the stop.
Kind of marvel at this Florida defense again. Just the guys they've played without over the last few weeks. ability to play at a high level with different guys in the lineup has been impressive.
I know defensive coordinator Jeff Collins puts his grad assistants to work there. The staff with the money down signs. Third and three. Quick strike to Rudolph.
I think that's his first catch, isn't it?
Yep.
Comes in as the leading receiver, the reliable guy in their offense, and his first catch of the night. In the slot, out, back in. They threw away from Tabor and away from Wilson, worked on the safety Marcel Harris that time, and the matchup favored Florida State for the first down.
30 straight games with a catch now for Travis Rudolph. Tackled for a loss. Zuniga with the effort there. Holly?
Well, some may have seen this, but for those who have not, a very special moment this year. Florida State went to visit a middle school as part of their community service, and just unbidden, just very naturally, Rudolph went and sat with a young man who had autism. Well, his mother captured that on video, this young man sitting by himself, and here comes this Florida State player and makes it cool to sit by this kid. Of course, it went viral. They've invited Bo Paskey to some of their games. He's become a part of this Seminole family, but a very sweet gesture by Travis Rudolph for a young man who needed some support.
Great example by Rudolph. And as he has been honored, as Whitfield makes the catch, Rudolph's been honored with sportsmanship awards, but setting forth a great example of how to treat others.
And actually, they're going to stay with base personnel. They've got three linebackers on the field right now on third and 10. This is not what they would normally want personnel-wise, but because of their injuries, that's what they're looking at.
At a certain point, you just have to have your best athletes
right
on the field.
Keep it simple and play with your best.
So deep. Third and 10 without Dawson. Francois over the middle, complete. Rudolph in space and into the end zone. Travis Rudolph. That little sixth grader, Bo Paskey's got a smile on his face right now, doesn't he? As the Noles push that lead to 11.
Again, no nickel back on the field. It was a two-deep coverage. They were running underneath with the inside receiver. Rudolph ran into a void, and Francois with time made a beautiful throw.
Rudolph's 46-yard touchdown reception makes it 17-6. Chris Thompson trying to find something, but he is met at the 20. Seventh touchdown of the year. You see the damage the Noles have done in the third quarters this year. Now the defense gets after Scarlett a bit as well. Frederick Jones with the tackle.
Well, guys, good news for Florida's defense. It looks like their cornerback Duke Dawson, who's also their nickel, will be able to return to this game. They've taped up that right ankle. He's running on the sideline and looks pretty good. They need him because their other nickel is their linebacker, Daniel McMillan, which is, of course, not a great matchup.
No, that's what they went with on that last play when they gave up the score to Rudolph. Will be on second and 9 as he muscles it to Callaway, and Callaway with a good burst out to the 37-yard line, 15-yard catch.
Now, one of the ways you avoid the problems you're having on third down is convert on second down. Second and 10, they get the nice completion to Callaway and move the sticks.
great day in college football with the college football playoff implications with what happened in Ohio State and Michigan. You know, when you talk New Year's Six bowls, we'll see how things play out, but outcome of this game could determine what happens with the Orange Bowl. Florida State could be the ACC selection there, with Clemson possibly going to the playoff. Sugar Bowl with a second team from the SEC, a New Year's Six bid, as he was trying to find Tyree Cleveland. Still limited output with the balance attack from Florida. Just 149 total yards. P. Ryan tries to fight for something extra there.
This Florida State defense has gotten better as the season has worn on. Early on, they gave up a lot of points, a lot of yards. In the last several weeks, Charles Kelly's group has played much better, and they have played over the last 3 years particularly good against this Florida offense.
Held BC to 7, Syracuse to 14. By the way, that Pitt-Syracuse score today blew my mind.
Yeah.
76-61.
Looked like a basketball score.
It did. Had a step up as Walker was coming in, and now looking to extend the play. Batted right in his face by Marquez White. Charles Kelly is loving it.
Just a four-man rush. Dropping 7 into coverage. They looked like they were going to bring more guys, but they didn't. Appleby's flushed out of the pocket, and a nice job by Marquez White, just kind of mirroring the quarterback and then getting a hand on the football when he threw.
Murray back to return the Townsend punt. Dalvin Cook tackled for a loss back at the 20 as a flag is down as well.
Illegal block in the back. Off. That penalty will be declined. Second down.
Yeah.
A few teams that depend on their defense more and ask more of them than what Jim McElwain's bunch delivers. His staff together. He went out, got Jeff Collins, who was the DC at Mississippi State, that team that went to the Orange Bowl. Left Dan Mullen's staff come over and be with Coach Mack and these Gators. There's Rudolph on 2nd and 12. It's Marcel Harris with the tackle, 5 yards there.
One thing Florida has not been able to do is that is get Francois on the ground. They've not sacked him tonight. Coming into the game, Florida State, one of the worst in the country at giving up sacks. They had given up 34 sacks with their young quarterback coming into tonight. 0 tonight. And as well as Florida has played in the back end and knocking some passes down, they haven't been able to knock that quarterback down.
Third and 6. Here goes Cook again, just tripped up by Harris.
Boy, really caught Florida thinking pass all the way. Great block by Wilson Bell. Watch number 78 pull and lead right on the linebacker. Florida thinking pass. Big block by Wilson Bell. And Dalvin Cook with the first down. Sometimes the best time to run the football is when everybody is expecting pass.
This time taken down by Brantley.
Penetration again. Gets into that crease between the center and the left guard. Shows his quickness. And a negative yardage play.
Rudolph is able to fight away from Harris.
Yeah, Harris was trying to rip the football out. He had him stopped for virtually no gain, but when he tried to rip the football out, Rudolph was able to break free and gain a couple yards.
Florida State going to aim their way towards a fourth quarter that could arrive at their ninth win of the season. Remember, that Louisville team went tumbling down earlier today. So could Florida State possibly be lined up to position themselves for a New Year's Six Orange Bowl invite from the ACC? 17-6, Saturday Night Football. We'll be back after this message and a word from our ABC stations.
Florida State 7 of 12 on third down tonight. The last third down, third and long, it was a Dalvin Cook run for the conversion.
First play of the fourth quarter. A third and eight for the Noles. Francois gonna run for it. Untouched and then slides down. 18-yard run.
He doesn't run much. He has great pocket presence, but he's going to see an opening right here as he goes back. Knows what he needs for the first down. Big green area in front of him, and he shows you that he can run when it's the smart thing to do. Dalvin Cook run the last third down. DeAndre Francois run that third down, and now 8 for 13 in the ballgame.
Look at how shifty he can be. And Florida knows all about that, especially in the fourth quarters of games. He did it to them last year as they rode him home with 150 yards in the fourth quarter last year in Gainesville. Only had 33 prior to the final quarter. He had 7 chunk plays. And he is that kind of back.
Well, you ride him now, and you can also ride the clock some as well.
Second and 7 carry here for Cook. And he's going to be close to that line to make, maybe just short, depending on that spot. Well-earned run from Cook.
Take a look here. Just, again, power running, stay behind and just zone blocking, find a crease. You get the ball deep to the back on that zone play. He can cut it anywhere in there. He just has to see it. And there are a lot of different places he can hit the line of scrimmage on that play.
230-pound Jaquez Patrick comes in as Cook trotted off. Third and one. They go to the up back, Stevenson, and he gets free. To the end zone, Freddie Stevenson's fourth score of the year.
Jeff Collins told us their fullback is a weapon. We have to account for him. Kylan Johnson is going to close in. He's going to hit Stevenson. He's going to hit him in the backfield, but he hits him with his back. He doesn't wrap up. He turns his body and just hits into him. And Stevenson just bounces right off of that and takes the football into the end zone.
As Logan Tyler came in to place kick there as the 298 consecutive PAT streak continues. Stevenson with the touchdown run to push the Noles lead to 18, 24-6. 14th ranked team in the country against the rivals ranked 15. You could use Thompson to provide a spark here. He will be forced to take a knee. It has been an interesting weekend with all these rivalries and the impact on the college football playoff, Todd. That's right. Penn State is playing incredibly good football down the stretch of this season. You can say what you want about what happened earlier in the year and the game against Pitt and the blowout loss to Michigan. They are doing everything they're expected to right now.
They got some guys back on defense healthy, and Trace McSorley, their quarterback, has played outstanding football.
Jordan Cronkright with a good run and a first down for Florida. And as just to reiterate for those joining us now, I asked your opinion on Ohio State. Everybody is just joining the chorus of, yes, second best team in the country.
Yeah.
Forget the fact they're not playing for a conference title. They're in your eyes.
I think they should be in, yes.
Just it was Christmas with the tackle there.
Amazing to me the mastery defensively that Florida State has had over the Gators in this three-game winning streak, trying to make it four in a row over Florida. In this current three-game winning streak, they've held the Gators to 246 yards a game, and they've only allowed two total touchdowns in three games. Well, now we're almost through four games, and they still haven't scored another touchdown.
Second and 11. Incomplete, trying to find Powell.
Should have been a caught there. That was a case of Powell looking at the defense.
Now look at the total yards and the points in the last three meetings now. Only gave up two last year, only giving up six right now. 0-for-9 on third downs, the Gators. Third and 11. Appleby taken down.
Well, I don't know. You got to turn out to take care of all the big guys. I mean, this is a big guy right here. This is not a linebacker or a defensive back. He has 8 sacks on the season, and nobody even touches him. That was a miscommunication on setting and identifying the protection. And Austin Appleby can't get away from Brian Burns.
Ball is out, scooped, and taken in for the score, Marcel Harris. They'll take it anywhere they can get it. Chris Thompson had a big hit, and Harris scooped and scored.
Chris Thompson just ripped the ball out. Watch 85 just get in there and rip the ball out before he's down.
Running on the field, the fumble, covered by the kicking team. Touchdown.
Your offense can't score. Your offense can't convert a third down. Turn to your defense and your special teams to get you back in the football game.
Any way it goes. As they are cranking it for a little special forces over there on the Florida sideline. And Pinheiro on to attempt the extra point.
As tired as this Florida defense might be, that could be a shot in the arm for him.
Marcel Harris in the right spot at the right time, scored for the Gators. Moments ago, Marcel Harris with the scoop and score after the punt return by Murray was fumbled. And now a 24-13 game we're sitting on here. Whitfield from inside the 5. As he gets into the clear out towards the 40. Holly.
Well, you will see a new addition to these Florida State helmets tonight, a number 42 in the initials MB. That is in honor of a beloved senior athletic associate director, Monk Bonasor, who lost his battle with brain cancer this week at age 59. Monk was a huge part of this team. In fact, I was talking to the softball coach today, Lonnie Alameda. She said she was sitting with him in some of the final days, and she was so touched by the many, many people who came to visit him, the lives that he had touched. His sons are here tonight. I got a chance to give them a hug on the sideline. There will be a memorial service for Monk Monday at 3 p.m. here on campus.
It was a very nice moment prior to kickoff. And as Cook was met by McMillan.
We talked about this at the beginning of the show, what Florida State was trying to accomplish with a win tonight. A 4-0 sweep for these seniors over Miami and over Florida. Jimbo Fisher, for him, would make him 17-1 against in-state opponents and 9-1 against SEC competition. It's pretty impressive record.
Sure is, and it matters a lot in terms of accumulating more and more talent with the recruiting riches of Florida. What a good block and a good surge and then a big hit. Yeah. As Francois went down, lost the ball.
That's the only reason I was wondering why you're running your quarterback at this point in the game, because you expose him to some hits like that. And that was a clean hit, but a big hit.
Marcel Harris.
That ball came out. I mean, he really ripped him.
And Tease Tabor secured that ball. The field is that it's Florida football. Now look at this big blast, and then the ball comes out.
I mean, you have an 11-point lead. You have one of the best running backs in the country. The question will be is whether they will overrule this, that he was down before the ball came out.
Ruling on the field of a fumble recovered by the defense stands. First down.
Just as Mr. Lamagne said it would. So Florida with 4:25 left with the ball, trailing by 11.
Trailing by 11 and 0-for-11 on third down.
You have to go back to 1980, the last time Florida State had a game in which an opponent never converted a third down. 1980. Is it ever loud right now? And Joe Campbell. Appleby pressured by Walker and thrown down. DeMarcus Walker is a beast.
A student of the game. He studies protections. He studies techniques. Watch him set up the right tackle. Quick up the field, an inside move. Too much for the freshman, Juwan Taylor. And when you know a team has to pass, you're at your best. And that's DeMarcus Walker time.
15 sacks on the year for Walker. Second and 22, Cleveland. The third and long.
This time they're going to move Walker inside and put Brian Burns, the freshman, outside of him. So you have the two best pass rushers on this Florida State defense on the same side.
There is that long and lean freshman. Here he comes. Nadi got to him. Walker has the ball in his grasp, and the Noles got it.
Well, that was Walker first that forced Appleby to move up in the pocket. They moved Walker inside. He's right here. He's going to get the first pressure and force Appleby up in the pocket. Right to Nadi, and then the ball comes out. And Walker ends up with the football. He started the play, and he ended the play. This has been a dominant performance by the Florida State defense. Six sacks, 167 total yards of offense, and 0-for-12 on third down.
as to his total. Did you see those outrageous numbers on DeMarcus Walker in his last two games against the Gators? Plus the fumble recovery on top of all of that.
Coaches rave about how he studies the game. He says, you know, we actually have some guys up front who are more athletic than him, but nobody works harder, prepares more, or understands what people are trying to do against him. He picks up run pass keys better than anybody, prepares like a pro, and will probably be one.
Stevenson, who had the touchdown earlier tonight with the carry.
Florida State team not going to be able to play in the ACC championship game. Probably still going to get a very good bowl assignment, maybe even a New Year's Six bowl.
Could be Virginia Tech, Clemson. Listen, if Clemson wins, they go to the college football playoff. So then you go with the highest ranked ACC team to backfill the Orange Bowl. That could likely be Florida State.
This team probably going to be without Dalvin Cook next year in all likelihood, but a very young, talented team coming back.
Because things have gotten wacky in the Big Ten, where the perceived second best team in the country will not be playing in the Big Ten title game. Instead, it's going to be Wisconsin and Penn State. And then you got things in the Pac-12 still to be decided with Washington and Colorado. And start framing the arguments as DeAndre Francois. You think it means just a little something in this rivalry? Francois able to celebrate the 8-yard touchdown run.
And guess who the lead blocker was? Dalvin Cook. It's a little quarterback counter. They pull a guard. He leads up, and Dalvin Cook, one of the best running backs in America, says, you know what? Get in my back pocket, young quarterback. Me into the end zone. Kind of like that. Francois fumbled on the one carry. They get him a chance to run it again, and he scores a touchdown.
Logan Tyler bounces it off the upright to keep that PAT streak alive for Florida State. Colorado and Coach McIntyre. Coach McIntyre has got to be the coach of the year, doesn't he, Todd?
I'll tell you what, he's had a phenomenal year. I think you're right, but Chris Peterson also, what he's doing at Washington, how they've played this year, that's an interesting matchup as well.
Conventional thinking is if everything holds form, if the SEC and the ACC, the favorites win, Ohio State's already in the clubhouse. There's going to be one spot to fight for.
That's where the committee is really going to get put to the test. How important conference championships are to them in trying to determine who the four most deserving teams are.
41 players between these teams came from just 15 high schools in the state of Florida. Yeah. 41 on only 15 schools. They have known each other for a long time, as teammates, as rivals, and now as college rivals.
And it's an interesting rivalry, too, as Holly touched on the very beginning of the show. Florida State, Florida wouldn't schedule them for the longest time. And then they were forced to schedule them. The Miami Florida State rivalry is a little bit more respectful. There's a little bit more bitter feelings in this one between the Seminoles and the Gator. The schools are closer together, and the feelings are a little bit more intense between the two schools.
And well, for years, Florida wouldn't play them, as you said. They wouldn't even come here. For the older fans, it means a lot, especially. Austin Appleby, 14 of 29 tonight, only 109 yards passing. As he cranks this up and gets it complete to Siante Lewis past midfield. All the injuries that Florida has had to deal with. And shuffling up that offensive line. As another strike to Lewis. Of course, Luke Del Rio was ahead of Appleby on the quarterback depth chart. There he is. We invite you to stay tuned for the Ford wrap-up after the game. Mac and Mark and Stan, curious to hear their opinions as to what has happened today. Cassidy's done a great job all night long as well. Final half minute here in Tallahassee. Appleby with Cronkright out of the backfield as he steps out inside the 30. Well, we call it the state championship down here. You go up against Miami and the Gators and fill it in, Todd. Last 4 years.
Yeah, that is that's big. You mentioned all these guys that know each other, played against each other, in many cases played with each other. Bragging rights over spring break.
Cronkright will get the first down here. 17-1 against in-state opponents since Jimbo Fisher became the head coach. Of course, USF on that list as well as an opponent. And this senior class for Florida State, the four-year guys, 8-0 now against Florida and Miami. That has never happened before, to have 4 years of a sweep of both.
And this is a young Florida State team that has a lot of talent that Jimbo Fisher has to work with in the next few years. And you know, recruiting will stay at a high level for Jimbo. Wow, that was Burns.
And he just had to get rid of it with Brian Burns on top of it. And then P. Ryan just trying to make the most of it as double zeros hit the clock. That is four straight wins over Florida for the Noles. And Jimbo Fisher, and what a night for Dalvin Cook. And doesn't he deserve it? 153 yards. Jim McElwain's got business to do, like getting ready to face his old boss in Atlanta. But this one means a heck of a lot. Jimbo Fisher is 6-1 now against Florida.
Another hug for Talbot. He's got one more game with him, wherever that might be in the postseason.
Let's go down to the field to Holly.
Well, Coach Fisher, I know that for your seniors, a special night to go out never having lost to the Florida Gators. What does it mean for you to see them do that?
It's unbelievable. And you know, that's the first class to ever go 4-0 against Miami, 4-0 against Florida in the history of Florida State. What these seniors have meant to this program and what they've all done, and very unbelievably proud of them and happy for them. And these kids deserve it. This guy right here, boy, is he pretty special.
He is pretty special. And Dalvin, you know, they have a sign up on the Jumbotron. Thank you, Dalvin. Was this your last game tonight? And if so, how proud are you of how you went out?
I'm proud of this team, man. The way we competed in this game, man. We got another game to go play, but we're going to enjoy this win right here. And, you know, I love this coach to death, man.
I did one of your first interviews ever on signing day, and you had big goals for yourself, and now you'll go out as the all-time leading rusher. What does that mean to you that you accomplished those goals?
It means a lot, man. This group right here, man, they did a great job. This O-line, man, I got to give it all to them and the receivers, you know. They did a great job of blocking for me and doing everything that he needed to do, and, you know, that's why we're sitting at the top all together.
Thank you very much, guys. Special night for both of you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Dalvin was awesome, but so was the defense. They didn't allow a third down conversion. The Gators were 0-for-12. Some defensive fireworks for the Noles. Holding a team without a third down conversion, Florida State hadn't done that since 1980. Held Florida only 207 total yards. Ninth win for the Noles. As we send it to Cassie Hoover back in the studio. So long, Tallahassee.